Hi everyone, I'm Elisa.
And I'm Robin. Today we're going to be talking about social media and how social media platforms can benefit brands and businesses by creating a better value and how they can use social media to achieve that. We will explain this by using our chosen business.
Before we go into details, we're going to briefly talk about social media. According to the Cambridge Dictionary, social media can be defined as platforms that allow people to share information over the internet using applications and online services. There are so many platforms today being used by consumers such as Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, Snapchat, and Twitter.
There are at least 3 billion users worldwide, making that 8 in 10 people active users. This has allowed us to connect with people from around the world, and it has essentially changed the way we communicate. We've moved from emails to instant messaging, from sharing photographs to sharing videos, and from standard phone calls to video calls. This can be due to the shift in consumer trends. We also have become more accustomed to reaction-based interaction, for example, liking and commenting on pictures or videos. Teenagers especially feel more excited when they receive likes or reactions, as it's a form of gratification. Social media is also quite time-consuming, as we found ourselves scrolling multiple times a day, whether it's for a couple minutes or an hour.
So, how can social media create better value for consumers? We're going to be talking about four types of value. First value is functional value. Functional value is the adding value for consumers through visual evidence of product. Secondly, experiential value allows consumers to experience the product in order to create their own value of the product. Thirdly, symbolic value gives consumers the chance to imagine themselves utilizing this product. And lastly, cost value. Cost value gives consumers the chance to look at the financial value, which allows them to become aware of the intangible return on the investment. For example, an iPhone could cost $1,500. They are aware of this financial cost. However, the intangible return is the gratification from using this product. The business we will be discussing is Paper Kites. Paper Kites is an online and brick and mortar clothing store slash brand based in Melbourne. They currently stock clothes for women between the ages of 16 to 24 years old. They currently have 5 physical stores in Melbourne, which are all in shopping malls. So we're going to look at their Instagram. By looking at their Instagram, they only have one highlight. This highlight is a circle underneath the description for Paper Kites. Paper Kites could create more highlights for new arrivals or other people wearing Paper Kites. They should add a customer review highlight to encourage conversations and show that there's engagement, as well as convey that there is a community surrounding the brand and creating strong relationships in the future. They could also incorporate more videos to their page. For example, it would help showcase clothes on a moving model. Furthermore, stories can be utilized so that consumers consistently stay up to date with the brand and that they don't have to actively search for it, which will increase brand awareness. The feed is currently not as engaging as it could be. They could repost photos of consumers wearing the clothes, making the brand feel more like a community, and also they could also reply to customer comments. Cost value can also be created by posting photos or promotions of sales and tagging items in pictures, which links directly to the website. Because they also have a physical store, a hashtag like PaperKitesOnMe would showcase what items you purchase, and they could repost these mirror selfies or items that consumers have bought to their page, and also to remind other consumers that Paper Kites also offers an in-store experience.
Next, we're going to talk about Facebook. This is the second social media platform we looked at. As Elisa mentioned with their Instagram, their engagement with their customers on Facebook is low too. Their last post was approximately a year ago. This shows that they've lost touch with this social media stream and the consumers that use this platform. They should start reposting to re-encourage a community. They also do not reference their products in their posts or add links to their products on their website. Thus, they should provide information in their captions and provide links to help the consumer know what products they've used in their posts and exactly where to find it. Yes, they do provide a link to their website, but not to the clothes that are on the model. This would make the consumer's shopping experience more streamlined.
Thanks for watching.
Thank you.